My father took charge of the first LG 1750 20 years ago, and I have the honor of driving the first LG 1800-1.0 in Wanderup near Flensburg for the first time. We want to replace the rotor shaft on the wind turbine in the background. To do this, the 150-ton rotor has to come down. Last week, we completely assembled the crane for the first time without any problems. Today, we did the first preparatory work and are now waiting for the right wind conditions to remove the rotor.
Nolte has built well over 1,000 wind turbines and, of course, also completed various industrial orders, with the LGs proving themselves time and again in these applications. Nolte had a total of 5 LG 1750s, which were replaced sporadically. I was actually considering whether to swap to a new LG 1750, but then came the new wind-related requirements, which go to even higher hub heights, where the machine can no longer reach. As a result, the decision was made to buy the LG 1800 in order to remain attractive on the market. We are staunch advocates of mobile cranes. They have certain advantages in wind turbine installation due to their constant ground pressures. We used to have 2 crawlers, but then we went back to the mobile crane equipment because, in my opinion, it's simply more flexible, especially in the wind. Detlef Schlesner took the first LG 1750, and now, after 20 years, with the delivery of the LG 1800, his son Rainer Schlesner has received the first LG 1800.
The crane stands here with 170 tons of slewing platform ballast and 130 tons of suspended ballast. The configuration of the crane is a 129-meter main boom and 12-meter lattice-type fixed jib. In this configuration, we have an approximate maximum lifting height of 144 meters. We took the rotor off at 27.5 meters and put it down at 31 meters. This was no big problem thanks to the Vario ballast. We actually drive all cranes, even the smaller telescopic cranes, because we have Licon 2, so the changeover is not that big. As there are other crane manufacturers, everything is completely new every time. That makes life difficult. For this mission, we had to move the suspended ballast over the full radius of 15.4 to 25.5 meters. For the complete rotor, we need a very long period with very little wind. In wind power, there are only single blades because they've become too heavy and too big. We turned the rotor with a 230 ton crane and then set it down on the ground together. With the different boom configurations, we can work up to a hook height of 203 meters. Yesterday, we removed the 147-ton rotor and set it down. And over the next few days, we'll carry out the rest of the work.
We have now reached a hub height of 180 meters, which is also what the crane is planned for, which will now be built in the future. So the basic plans are in place, and we expect to be executing the first job for this 180 meter hub height next year.